Hello people, this is Aryan from Code Grind, and in today's video we'll be continuing our long series of text CSS text animations. And in this video we'll be creating this amazing bouncy text animation using Google Fonts Luckiest Guy font. In the previous videos we have covered three different kinds of text animations. The first one was this funky animation with this popping effect and also the rotation one. The second one was this ice cream sandwich text animation, and the third one was the neon text lighting animation. And in this video we'll be talking about this bouncy text animation. So this is going to be the last video for now for this series. I'll put a pause for this series, that it has been a long journey for this one, and from the next videos I'll be covering some new topics. So now let's have a look at what this will look like. So as you can see, we have got these different letters, and they're all bouncing and forming a wave kind of thing. So let's see how we do it. So let's get straight into it. So here I've got this basic layout ready. I have linked an external CSS file in which we'll be doing the styling part. Now let's get started with the HTML. So we just need an H1 tag, and for every letter we'll be using the span tag. So for C, then for O, same for D and E. You can obviously have any other word if you want. So, and after the first word is completed, just use the break tag, then span again for the next word. G, R, I, N, and at last D. Okay, so we have got our H1 tags and all the letters over here. Now let's move to the styling part. So for styling, the first thing which we need to do is import the font. So for that, just visit this Google Fonts website. I'll give a link in the description for it, and search for the font Luckiest Guy. And here you will see the font. Just click on it and click on this select this style option. So here you will get two different options. The first one is this link option. You can just copy this code and place it inside your head tag and use the font. The second one is this option which I'll be using. Copy this import line. You can use it inside your style tag and also in your CSS file. Just paste it inside here, and to use it, simply use the syntax, which is luckiest guy, comma cursive. Now let's get into our styling. So we'll select our H1 tag. Actually, first of all, we need to select our body tag and give it a background color of sky blue. So we'll be doing that, and after that we'll also apply this font family of luckiest guy to this. So for that, as you saw on the website, luckiest guy comma cursive. Okay, so we've got that font applied. Now for the H1 tag, the first thing which you need to do is margin top, so that it's positioned a bit better than how it is positioned now, and then text align of center. Okay, so we have got this done right. And now we'll select each one of the span tags and give them a position of relative top of 20 pixels. Okay, that worked. And then we'll give the font size, just increase it to 80 pixels and change their color to white. Okay, that looks much better now. And after we provide this text shadow property, it will look very amazing, and it will give this text the 3D effect. So simply use the text shadow property, and we'll be using this thing. So what are these values? So the first value over here is 0, is the horizontal offset, which means a positive value to the horizontal offset will provide a text shadow to the right side of the text, and a negative value will provide a shadow to the left side of the text. Since we have provided it with 0, we don't see anything. If I save it, still you won't see anything. Let me change the color. So now you see we have got this slightly black shadow, as you can see after I've zoomed it in, but there is nothing to the right side, just to the bottom, because now the second value is the vertical offset, which means a positive value will provide a shadow to the bottom of the text, and the negative value will provide a shadow to the top of the text. If I change this to minus, you see the shadow is formed on the top of the text, but we just need this one, and let's change this back to CCC. Okay. Now after this, we need to provide some more shadows. So to provide multiple shadows, just separate them using commas. We will just keep on increasing the vertical offset, and other values will remain the same. And And now after we have provided it up to 5 pixels, now we'll be using 6 pixels, and now the color won't be there, just it will just be transparent. So the reason for using this transparent, I will tell about it later on. We'll provide this transparent up to 9 pixels. I have simply copied them down while I tested them, and I'm now just copying them from the other screen. Okay, so up till here it was transparent, and at last over here we'll have this 10 pixel 10 pixel, and now we'll have RGBA 0 0 0 and blur of 0.4. okay, so now what is this transparent? So if you look closely, you will see that this layer has been formed over here, this gray layer. So this is the 0.1 pixel CCC to 0.5 pixel CCC. This layer is formed by these 5 values, and after we provided 6 pixel to 9 pixel this transparent, it formed a gap between the black shadow and this grayish layer, and this 10 pixel 10 pixel is this blurred shadow. So I did not tell you about this third value. This one is the horizontal offset, this is the vertical, and this one is the blur radius. So this is the blur radius of the shadow which will be formed, and here we have chosen this black color. So a shadow of black color with the 10 pixel blur has been formed. So this is how to use the text shadow property. And then now we need to provide each span tag with a animation. So we'll call that animation bounce for 0.3 seconds in finite. Okay, now let's define that animation. So 100%. So at the last stage, what we want is the top to be minus 20 pixels so that it looks like it's shifting upwards and it's bouncing. And then we'll have its text shadow changed as well. So now the text shadow will be like this only. So let's copy this actually. And now for 6 pixels also it will remain CCC, for 7 also. So there won't be any transparency now. Everything will have a color. And now at last this 10 pixel 10 pixel won't be the values in this case, and at 100% it will be 50 pixels and 25 pixels. And this will change to 0.2, this blur of the black color. So now you see all of this is bouncing at the same time, and we just see the animation once. So the animation is like just when it's shifting upwards, but when it's coming down again, we don't see the animation. So for that, just provide it with this alternate keyword so that the animation is occurring both the times. So now you see it's slowed down a bit. So it's taking actually 0.6 seconds now, because once while going up, once while going down, because of this alternate keyword. But now all of this is bouncing at the same time. So to provide each letter with a bit of a delay, what we'll do is simply select each and every one of the letters. Not the first letter, of course. So the second letter. So these are the child type selectors. If you want to learn about them, then go watch one of my videos where I talked a lot about these child type selectors. I'll give a link in the description, and you can also click on the link above. So we'll simply give them an animation delay of 0.1 second. So now you see we have got this delay on O. Now let's just copy this for every letter. We have a total of 9 letters. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. This will be 3, and to that we'll have a delay of 0.2 seconds. Then 4, 3, 5th letter, and delay of 0.4 seconds. So I think you have got the concept of what we are doing over here. And at last, the last letter, and the delay will be 0.8 seconds. So now you see we have got this very amazing bouncy effect with that wave formation for both the words. And this is how you can apply this bouncy text animation, this bouncy 3D text animation to any of your text. And if you like the video, then don't forget to hit the like button, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. So thank you for watching.